Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, I'm going to show you even more tricks on how to use the Teach Target on Surface feature to your advantage, and I'm going to show you how to recover from one of the most common mistakes you'll do while using RoboDK. This one is very interesting. Let's jump right into it. So here we have the station exactly how we left it at the end of the other video. So I will hide the object here. So hide the object, hide the frame. I'm going to bring the robot back to its home position, and I will open the robot panel so that I can simply rotate the tool 180 degrees. I can enter that specifically here. Okay, great. So let's start by creating our target for this specific part here. So as you can see, it's an arc circle, so it would create a perfect cylinder if I was to continue that part around. This means that we can create circular motions for this one. So we can avoid creating a bunch of small targets everywhere and just create one target here, one target somewhere in the middle, and one target at the end. So this is how circular motions work in general. You have to give an intermediary point and an end point. We will see how to create circular motions in the next video, but for this one, we'll have to create the targets that come with it. But here, our main challenge will be to have the robot tool in the right orientation, because it wouldn't be super effective if we were to inspect the part with the camera field of view in this direction. As you can see in this case here, the field of view is more like a rectangle than a square. So the orientation of the tool will matter a lot in terms of how much you can cover in one pass. So instead of doing like multiple small passes, if we were able to kind of rotate the tool 90 degrees, it would be awesome. We could potentially do that in just three passes. So this is what we'll do. First, if you go and click Program Teach Target on Surface, you will have access to the same panel as before. I'm going to uncheck Snap on Arc Circle. We don't need it. I'm going to demonstrate this difference between normal and constant. My goal here is not to use constant, it's to use normal again, but I want to show you the difference, and that's a good use case. So if you bring your mouse on top of this surface here, you can see that you are always, as the setting suggests, normal to the surface, which is awesome. If you were to use constant, the distance between the TCP and the surface is always the same, so it's kind of flat on the surface. But as you can see, it does not follow the orientation of the surface. It will simply snap on the surface by keeping the orientation of the tool as it was positioned before you launched the actual feature. Let's go back to normal. So there's two ways of rotating the tool in this case. The first way would be to use one of those three little wheels. So obviously the colors refer to the rotation around a given axis of the TCP. So blue for rotation around the Z-axis, red rotation around the X-axis, and then green rotation around the Y-axis. So if I click here and rotate that, you can see that my ghost or semi-transparent tool will rotate around. So you could do that here and start creating targets like that. If you want to reset that to the original position, you can simply click on Reset Orientation. You can also just bring your mouse here and use your keyboard arrows either up or down, left or right, same exact result, to rotate around the last wheel that you selected. So you see there's one like this little bit highlighted in blue. If I was to click on the red one would be highlighted and I would control the rotation around the x-axis with my arrows. So that's the first method on how to manage orientation of your tool while doing Teach Target on Surface. The other method requires you to leave the Teach Target on Surface, and you simply need to orient your tool the way you would like it. So for this one, I will click like that here. And I would say, okay, let's activate the robot base here so that we can have here 0, 0, and the rest seems to make sense. Perfect. So that's great. So now if I click program teach target on surface, it will take this orientation as my reference, and the robot will already be positioned in the right orientation here. So if I come here, I can click in the middle, and then click towards the end like that. So the way the robot is positioned before you get started will kind of be your reference for the targets you will create. So like that, create another target somewhere in the middle, third target here, or sixth in fact, another one here, another one somewhere here, doesn't matter, just need to be somewhere along the curve, and then a last point here. So just like that, I created 9 points. They are all normal, the surface. I created a row that is like on the edge, another row that is on the edge, and some points in the middle. Those will be useful for my circular motions. I voluntarily did something wrong here. And I say voluntarily because I did it this time voluntarily, but this is one of the mistakes I'm doing the most often. So I'm always doing that. What did I do wrong? I forgot to activate the right reference frame before creating all my targets. So right now it's a bit problematic. All targets are with respect to the robot base, and I'm kind of stuck with that. So what I can do is select all of those. The first reflex you would have is to potentially drag and drop that to frame inspection B, and now all the targets like went in a weird position. As we already mentioned in a previous video, this is because all of those targets have a relative position with their parent reference frame. And when you're drag and dropping stuff, you are keeping that relative position and applying it to a new reference frame somewhere else. So that means that the position target one was with respect to UR frame URE base here is respected, but the reference frame is here and the robot reference frame was there. So that gives you kind of a weird position. So what you can do to recover from that, you need to do the same thing backwards. So you need to bring back the targets here. You need to select the targets, right click, change support, and now you can select the frame you want. The difference here is that's a switch of parent, but in a static way. So the absolute positions of the target are kept, only the parent is changed. I'm gonna select all of that, right click, and then I'm gonna rename the group, call that inspect B, click OK, and that's it. Okay, that's pretty much everything for this video. In the next one, I'm gonna show you how you can create your program using MoveCs for this one. We'll also add our approach and retract motion, and I'm gonna show you a very cool trick on how to create main program very quickly compared to the normal method. I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day, guys.